Hi guys, and welcome to Matt Bajeski YouTube channel. Welcome to your YouTube channel. It's a beautiful day here in Laurel Canyon. I hope you're doing all right, guys. I hope life is becoming easier, even through the challenges that we all go through from day to day, week to week, month to month, year to year. I hope you're learning, you're working on letting go of things quicker, which means that you're able to live in more happiness, peace, and more balance than the stress and the fear and the worry of the what ifs and why that happened. I think a good little practice is letting go of things and letting the universe take over, meaning that if you just let it go and say to yourself, give yourself maybe 4 weeks, just give yourself 4 weeks, whatever issue it is, give yourself 4 weeks, which means I won't worry about it and look at it in 4 weeks. And you will see the shift in energy instantly within you. And in 4 weeks, you'll look back and realize, I'm so glad I didn't react. I'm so glad I didn't knee jerk. I'm so glad I didn't spend hours thinking about it. And another good thing as well is to repeat to yourself is, everything's just an illusion. I often get people say, well, what's the point of living here if everything's an illusion? Well, I think I try and make light heart of it by saying everything's an illusion because nothing really matters. And you would say, well, you know what, my dog is, you know, got cancer, or my child is ill. Yeah, that's different. Everybody tries to put one meaning to everything, and no matter what meaning you feel at this moment you're going through, what challenge it is, you'll put that meaning to what I'm saying. So it's very challenging for me to make a video and to touch everybody's heart in a certain way, because there's always going to be people, you know, being angry or aggressive, you know, just by like the clothes I wear, what, you know, what I put on me. People look at me and judge me by the clothes I wear, you know, is it real, is this, and who is that you're wearing, who's that on you, and then everything is judged in its own way by that person and how that person is feeling, or how that person has been educated, or how they've been influenced with certain subjects in their life. So we all are opinionated and have judgment with our life lessons, really. So there's nothing I can do, really, to convince everybody that my truth is a real truth, because I can't, because your truth is your real truth. That's who you are. That's your purpose. That's your path. That's your journey. And my truth is my truth. And what I've learned along my path is completely different from what you've learned on yours. There may be snippets of the same feelings and thoughts and certain things that have happened to you which are similar to me, but your process of dealing with those things are going to be completely different. And what bothers me won't bother you, and what, you know, what I get excited about won't excite you, because we've been programmed in different ways. Our cultures, the way we are in life, the way we see things, the way we've been hurt, the way with, you know, the happiness that we see within certain things. You know, I'll give you a little story. I had a friend who really struggled with living in a house that had neighbors, and everywhere she went, she had issues with the neighbors all the time, and I found that fascinating. And I was trying to understand why that she was moving from house to house, because at first when I was reading for her, I was thinking, is it the energy in the house, is it that? And then I come to realize it wasn't any of those things. It was her issue with neighbors. And I found it, you know, I had to sit on the fence with this one, so to speak. Neighbor's fence, and try and understand it, because my experiences with my neighbors when I was a young boy was, my neighbor was called Keith, and Keith was like a second dad to me. My first dad just beat me up in the garden, but Keith had his garden, and he was like a 70s you know, the 70s hippie child. Well, his garden was filled with herbs and all this, and my dad was just, you know, very rigid tomatoes, runner beans, don't you step in, you know, the soil, and or you're going to get smacked, and marrows and, you know, onions. And in the next garden, Keith would have all these amazing herbs that I would be fascinated by and smelling and tasting, and he'd share all his wealth and information. Him and his partner never had children, so they saw me getting beat most days in the garden, and I think they felt really sorry for me. So they made a gate in between the fence, and I remember one day he said to, you know, my dad, "Hi Stanley, would it be possible if I put a gate here so your son can come and play in my garden too and look at the things?" And my dad said, yes, okay, real quick, no problem. And I used to go into his garden. He used to teach me all about herbs, and I lost all that information as I grew up, but I learned a lot from him, I remember. And I got so much excitement and joy when I used to run in the garden, not because of my own garden, because it had a swing, but because I went next door and I'd hope that Keith were there. And sometimes I'd go in round the back and knock on the door, hoping that they were in. So they treat me like a son as well. So I was very lucky as well with that. And I've never had an issue with neighbours per se, but this friend of mine did, and when she was younger, she had a massive issue with their neighbours, and there was a conflict with family to family, and they would fight every day and hate each other. So what I'm trying to say is that your situation to my situation will always be different. We will never see the same. We will never feel the same about any situation in life. And I think there has to be a respect there, and that's what we've lost. We've lost the respect for other people's path and journey. So we just see our journey in a selfish way and say to people, what the hell's wrong with them? Without thinking, well, you know what? That's their journey, and their whatever negative energy and whatever negative thoughts, feelings, and the way they behave comes to you is not about you. It's about what they've been through. And we have to learn, and I've tried to share this with you time and time again, you must never knee-jerk to somebody else's negativity, because they're going through their stuff and it isn't your stuff. And I often share this one with you. If anybody does that, you should sit down instantly and say, thank goodness I'm not like that anymore. Because you can judge yourself on a lovely measuring stick by the way somebody reacts to you and how you don't react to them. And like we always say, karma is very simple. How somebody reacts to you is their karma, and how you react back to them is your karma. So I do my best in not reacting, or if I do, I make it very quick and then stop it instantly, because I can't tell you not to react. If somebody comes and slaps me across the face, of course I'm going to react. But if somebody says you this and you that, first of all, I'm going to feel it, and there's nothing wrong with that. Feel it, and then ask yourself why that happened. Was what just happened, was it, how do I put this? Did I deserve that? I would ask myself that. So if you came up to me on the street and said, you did it, and then I say, okay, I'm sorry. I naturally say, I'm sorry that you feel this way. And then I go. What I do then is process it. I start to think, what just happened there? And then I think, did I deserve that? Did I say something? Did I do something that caused that effect? If so, then I would apologize and call them later and say, I'm so sorry, you're right. That was totally my fault, my issue. If I've processed that, and by the way, there's no bias in there, there's no proud man in here, because that it won't work then. No, there's no stubbornness when you do this. You do it out of love and well, not just out of love, but out of growing, out of growth, spiritual growth. So then you look at yourself and really, you know, turn the tables around, which I often do. I get myself in their shoes and then say the same thing to me as if I was them. And that sometimes helps as well, because you've got to look at other people's points of view of why they're upset. And then when I've done that, if I think, okay, no, I didn't deserve that, I don't feel as if I did anything wrong there, what would happen then is I would then say, thank goodness I'm not like that anymore. And I then instantly send them healing and, you know, say I hope you feel better in a loving way, which means I am strong enough to look at my weaknesses if they are there. I'm strong enough to say sorry, and I'm also strong enough to say this isn't affecting me, and I'm sending them love, because ultimately if they're happier and they feel happy that day, then they're not going to be upset with anybody else and scream and shout at anybody else. And ultimately you just want people to be happy in general. So that is strength, that's power, that's spiritual growth. What does that sound like? Does it sound okay? I mean, a lot of the times it's really difficult, because you can be in situations where you say, you know what, I didn't do anything wrong here, and this person just keeps on at me. Well, at that point you've got to make the decision that, you know what, this isn't healthy for me, and it certainly isn't healthy for them, and you walk away with love. So you know, I walked away from certain members of my family because they didn't understand me. I didn't want to go through that pain and suffering. Some beautiful birds here, as you can hear. And because of that, it made my life so much easier. And every day I send love to my family and hope that they feel stronger and happier, and they get over whatever the pain and suffering and challenges we all have to go through. And the same with friends. Certain friends just don't understand me because of my thought process now, the way I live, the way I dress, the way I talk, the way I share my truth. Some people just can't cope with it. It's just impossible, because they want you to be in their box, their world. And so you have to learn to grow. And like many, I think there's something in this, guys. I'm not so sure if you know this, but I've come to a conclusion in life that the people that you most respect and admire, please think about this, there's a connection here. What did they do in their life to actually shine so bright? And I think one of them is to walk away from where they lived. So if you believe in a man called Jesus, he was, I believe, a carpenter, a carpenter's son, and he left where he lived. Was it Nazareth? I'm not so sure. I was Catholic, but I forgot Nazareth. And he left because he knew, like, most of the sages, the gurus, the beautiful people who shine a light, they can never be who they're meant to be if they're still in their hometown, because people will always see them as that little child growing up to be that person. And I don't think they can understand that and allow them to be or to grow or to be who they're meant to be. So I think if you're wondering why you are still the way you are, and you want to grow, you want to become stronger, you want to share your gift, you want to be somebody, but you can't because you're stuck in your environment, I think that is a gift I share with you today. It is a key secret that opens the door to who you truly are. At 38 years old, I had a calling to leave my home and to go to another country. It was only then that I started to blossom to be who I was meant to be. And it's not anybody else's fault. They're not holding you back. You're holding yourself back by allowing them to treat you in the way that they've always known you. But how can you grow if only people will ever know you as the person that you've been as a child up till now? So sometimes you have to leave where you live to become who you were born to be. That's a little nugget of gold information for you guys. It might inspire you to maybe go and leave your home for a while and find a new home for a while, even if it's for a year. You make a decision to say, okay, I'm going to come back, so you're not fearful of what's going to happen, but maybe give yourself 1 year in another country and see what happens. You'd be surprised how spirit leads you to certain places and can change your life, because the place where you are now is perfectly set for you to be free and to be who you are meant to be without fear and worry of and repercussion of what anybody else will say. I think that's a big thing. I mean, the Buddha left his family. Jesus obviously left, and so many other people who needed to find themselves and to be who they are. And that's it, I guess, guys. I was going to talk about two crystals today, and I think we've still got time. It's going to be a short video about these two crystals, but it's Moldavite, which is the lucky winner is going to get that sent on Monday. Well done, lass. I'm wearing it and charging it. So, the Moldavite and Brandenburg. These two crystals together have worked alongside me for many a years and have proven to be one of the most magical and inspirational crystals that I've ever worked with. When you're in the art of meditation, when you're in the art of higher self, when you're wanting to find out who you are, where you're going in your path, what your journey is, and it really helps your intuition. It helps you awaken the very power and core within you. It also helps with spiritual connection. And I'm trying to recall certain situations where having these two crystals on really made a difference to me. I recall the time when I was wearing both these crystals at a ceremony that I asked everybody to come to the beach. And on the beach, we were all sat round in a circle. And I gave an opening talk, and a very beautiful lady did an om, and it went all around the circle. And then we sent healing into the middle of the circle. I remember holding the Brandenburg and the Moldavite as we were doing the sending of beautiful energy to people who needed it. This is fascinating, by the way. I'm not so sure if I wrote about this, but anyway, I had both crystals in my hand. I had my eyes closed, and all of a sudden, like Brandenburg and Moldavite together, it opens up like a doorway, like a new, I can't say doorway. I take that back. It's not doorway. It opens up a new energy within your attunement. And all of a sudden, what I saw was something so profound. I wrote about it a couple of times. And what happened was, around us, and in the center of the circle, I don't know what we'd done, whether it was a fire. It might have been a fire, or we created something in the center of the circle. But anyway, a light. I had these two crystals in my hand, and all of a sudden, a light appeared that shone down into the center of the circle, and everybody, I could feel this amazing power. And all of a sudden, this is what blew me away. All of a sudden, I saw this lady with long blonde hair and a little girl holding each other's hand walk through the circle, and I realized it was spirit. And as they walked through the circle, they went into the light and they just vanished. And within 30 minutes of this happening, I saw at least between 10 and 15 souls who were moving into the light from the area around. When I'd finished, I asked a couple of mediums, did you feel anything or see anything? Nobody experienced what I experienced. I asked, there were three mediums, a lot of spiritual people there. Nobody experienced what I experienced, which I found fascinating, because these guys were pretty worked in this field of work for a long, long time. So I realized that this beautiful crystal, Brandenburg with Moldavite, certainly opens you up to see things a lot more clearer. So these two crystals together amazing for people who are wanting to really move forward in the art of learning, feeling, experiencing, and strengthening their attunement to spirit. Also, I believe it helps with your ability to strengthen your own power to clear situations around you. Obviously, you all know about Moldavite already. Moldavite has that ability to basically smash down the walls, blow things out, cause a lot of stress and issue to people around you, but not in a negative, it awakens their power, it heals them, it makes them feel bad at times, but how Moldavite can work around people. But Brandenburg together brings, I think, a more balanced energy, which makes them feel more at peace, the spiritual at peace energy. So if this is about you and you're wearing a Moldavite and Brandenburg, it will obviously heighten your emotions. It will heighten your levels of seeing things and feeling things to a higher degree. But I think the Brandenburg brings balance to that and helps you understand, see clearly, helps you connect to the truth. So I think the Moldavite is the blast and Brandenburg is the balance, to balance that, to help you. So I think it's a good mixture. I think it's one of my favorite mixtures when I'm working alongside people who are very deeply stressed with life. Anybody who has maybe tried to take their life, anybody who feels really, really emotionally unstable with life. I think anybody who is going through biggest challenging moments, I think these two crystals together work very well. Yes, it will. If you're already feeling bad, I don't think by putting these two on, you will feel like 10 times worse, but I think it will bring out that what is suppressed and that seeps out where you feel bad all the time. I think this blast through that, yes, you will feel it just as much, but then it will release and then the Brandenburg works its magic and then opens you up to a higher, more in tune understanding and release, so you're able to move forward. And I think that's a good thing. A lot of people are stuck these days and they often get this feeling of, why do I feel so crap? Why is everything, why do I always feel this? And I understand that. I get that, because a lot of us don't really know what suppressed energy is, blocks, because we're trying to figure out, well, I'm okay today, everything's okay, so why do I feel so bad? Well, when you wear Moldavite, it brings that to light. And what this does is help clear that. So it's a great marriage. It's a great combination. And I think when people ask me which are your favorite crystals to put together with Moldavite, obviously Herkimer Diamond is one of my favorites. But Brandenburg certainly works on the level I've just tell you, more than any other crystal. Brandenburg is an amethyst, by the way, so if you can't find Brandenburg itself, then just get an amethyst. It's equally as beautiful. But Brandenburg has a very special meaning to me. It helped me through one situation that no other crystal did. So Brandenburg is an extremely beautiful crystal when you're going through heartbreak, sadness, pain, suffering, and you don't know why all of these things are happening and why you behave the way you do and why all and what's going wrong. And anytime you're unsure about your life, you don't know what's going on, if you wear these two together, it will bring it to light and you will be healed from it. And that's it, really. That's my experience with Moldavite and Brandenburg. Some people call it Brandenburg. It doesn't matter. It's there. It's beautiful. I do have a few on my website, but not many now, guys. The ones that I've got are very high quality Brandenburg, so you can get them cheaper in other places. But mine are really high quality. They're the best I could ever find. They're absolutely amazing. So that's it, really. Yes, I think that's it. I hope this video serves you well. I hope you're all having a lovely day today. And whatever challenges and tests we're going through, try the 1 month test. Give it a go. And always say to yourself, you know what, guys? Well, you know what? Everything is just an illusion, and it really is just an illusion. It's how you react to those illusions, those tests, that really make the difference in the world. So look at your reaction today, look at how you're behaving, look at how you're feeling. That is the most important thing you need to change if it is of a low energy. And yes, I guess that this fits in really nicely. Moldavite and Brandenburg together may just help you if you don't understand what's going on within you and around you. It may just bring to light, bring to the surface the real reason why you feel the way you are, and it may not have anything to do with what you thought was wrong with you. Okay? Have a great day, guys. I really mean that. Have a great day. Take care. Bye. Thank you for subscribing to Matt Bayeski YouTube channel. Bye.